I'm the son of an illustrator. I'm the son of a cartoonist. My dad was a cartoonist and editor for the Chicago Defender. And so I saw what he did and kind of, you know, I grew up emulating him. And so when I got out of high school and went to the Art Institute, it was pretty much guaranteed that I was going to pursue a career as an artist. And my first job was in advertising. And when I got that job, I met a lot of other young artists who worked in comics. And that was my initiation to becoming a professional comic book artist. So that was the start of it. And I'm a penciler, so I just finished a run on Vertigo's Jack of Fables. And then I have a project coming up for Dark Horse that I can't talk about yet, but you should hear about it in the next couple of weeks.
Oh, we don't get that scoop.
I can't. It's not my scoop to hand out just yet. So, but there are other projects coming up at Vertigo. I'm going to try to land a Supergirl gig today. We'll find out if that happens. And there are a couple other things in the works. And you know, and that's kind of how it is sometimes. You always got stuff in the works. How you do it is you put it first before everything else. You put it before sports. You put it before sleep. You put it before feeding yourself. And you make it's passion. That's what pulls you along. That's the sail that you pull up the mast every day. That's what gets you there. And then once you've got that, that's all you need. And just know, get yourself to a place where you know what you do is on the mark, that you can hold your own with other artists, and in some cases against other artists. Just be confident and do your best. Oh, well, the exciting parts are any new script. You get a new script in, and you read it, and it's the ideas. It's the possibilities that are going to come to you from doing this page. And sometimes it's, you know, doing something that you've done before that's familiar to you, that you know that works, so you have confidence in that. But it's also the challenge of doing something that's unknown, unfamiliar. And in that's also the downside, you know, coming across a challenge that's unfamiliar and you're unsure how you're going to make it work. But you're confident that you're going to make it work somehow. It's important to always be challenged. Always be challenged with what you do. Drawing a monthly book, you know, each page, each issue is that child, you know, and some of those children, some of those issues of my current series, Jack of Fables, some of those children did well. A couple of the children I threw under the bus, you know, because...
Before they even got anywhere?
Oh, you know, it's just like, you know, it's just not going to make it. There's something... just not right about the boy, and you just gotta go on. But you know, you still love that child, and you still foster it. But you just like, no, it's just not right, and you let it go. So there are children that just should not have gone out into the world. You know, a couple of stories for PETA for a fundraiser. But that's how you establish your boundaries. Your capacity to work is by doing these things.
What's on the agenda that you want to do that you have not done already?
Oh, obviously directing. I mean, this from doing this, it's moving on to filmmaking. And I'm not saying directing actors, but probably doing some animation, some short animation pieces with a crew of animators, because I enjoy working with other artists. So that's probably the next thing I'll do that's not comic related.